Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This is lecture number 39th. The name of the paper is Literary Criticism 1. The name of the book is On the Sublime by Longinus. The topic is False Sublime. And this lecture is specifically for the students of BS English 5th semester GDC Pabi. And it is also for the students of those colleges which are affiliated with Abdul Wali Khan University. We know that Hellenistic writers, they followed the outer form and the rules. Hellenistic writers lived between 323 BC to 31st BC. That age was called Hellenistic Age. This followed the death of Alexander, which happened in 323. Up to 31st BC. These writers followed the outer form, just like the 18th century writers, Pope and Dryden. They also followed the outer form and they believed in rules. However, though the outer form was like the classic writers, but there was no spirit in it and there was no inspiration in their writings. This was about the Hellenistic age, and that age we know did not have any sublimity in it. Longinus mentions four faults in the type of writing which does not have sublimity or which is considered as false sublime by Longinus. If some writing or an age where the sublime is missing or which has false sublime will have these four faults in their writing. These faults, especially this one, following the outer form, ignoring the inner spirit, that was the fault of the Hellenistic age. And the other faults, which actually causes false sublime, not the true sublime, are these. Longinus mentions the first fault, that is referred to as turgidity or timidity. Timid means which is not brave. It is its literal meaning. And turgidity also means complicated, but here it refers to the inflating words and actions. Inflating words and actions means that the words are high-flown words, big words, but the thought is not big. So this defect is referred to as turgidity, in which inflated words are used, the grand style is used, and the grand style is fitted with the with something which is not very grand. That is, the thought is not grand. Longinus tells us about the relationship between matter and manner. Matter is the thought behind the writing, and manner is the way in which something is written. For example, that would include a diction and style, and matter is that thought which is extremely important, according to Longinus, for sublime writing. Longinus tells us about the fact that there should be a balance, there should be a relationship between matter and manner. While this fault, which is referred to as turgidity, is the kind of fault which arises when there is an imbalance in thought, that is, in matter and manner, in thought and style, which is equivalent to matter and manner. If they are imbalance, then turgidity will be the result. So thought, as we know, must be in harmony with the style. If the thought is great and if the thought is not great and the style is great, then this is imbalance. If the thought is great and the style is not great, it is again imbalance. So this fault, according to Longinus, occurs when the thought is not great, but the form, that is the outer structure, is great. The words used are great words, and such a language which expresses the lesser thoughts in grand style or grand words is called bombastic language, the high sounding language in which there is less meaning. The words are big, with the meaning it expresses not very big, or it isn't in harmony with the thought with the subject matter. Longinus compares it with a disease. The disease is that kind of disease in which a person gets fatter and fatter, but he actually is hollow inside, just like a balloon, an inflated balloon, which is empty inside. This cannot be considered as the sign of health. If somebody is fatter and he is hollow inside, this is not the sign of health. This is considered as a kind of disease, and the name of that disease is dropsy. Dropsy is the disease in which the person gets fat, from fat to fatter, but inside he is shallow. Therefore, that poetry, which has a very big style, bombastic style, bombastic diction, is there. There is heroic meter, but such style, diction, and heroic meter is not in harmony with the subject matter, and therefore it suffers from dropsy, and therefore it is diseased poetry. This fault occurs even in great poets, and Longinus gives us a psychological reason why this fault comes into even great writers and great poets. He says that such poets who indulge in this fault are afraid of appearing mean and low. This is the cause of this fault, that the poet starts fearing the fact that he might become mean and low. Mean and low means that his writing might become simple and unimpressive, and this fear results in this fault of turgidity and timidity. Even in 18th century, Wordsworth, we know, was a great poet, but he wrote poems sometimes in which he was not inspired while writing those poems. When he was inspired, he wrote wonderful poetry, but sometimes he would not be inspired, and even then he would write poetry, and that poetry resulted in flatness, hollowness, and that was a kind of forced poetry. So though he was a very great poet, he also suffered sometimes from this fault of turgidity, and this is therefore not limited to inferior poets. It can be found in great poets as a fault. And with this, when this fault is there in a poem, that poem is not a sublime poem. So this is the first fault. The first fault is that of turgidity or timidity, when the words used are very big, the style is great, but the thought itself is not great. So there is a kind of disharmony in the subject matter and in the words. The second fault is referred to as puerility. The literal meaning of puerility is silly, childishly silly, and also immature. There are many reasons, different reasons for this fault. One of them is that the writer becomes a pedant. Pedant is the one who wants to display his learning, but he displays his learning by artificial ways, by not sincere ways, and he deliberately makes his style higher than normal. When you deliberately do something, when that something doesn't come naturally to you and you do it deliberately and it is forced, then it becomes artificial. So the difference between scholarship and creativity is great. Shakespeare, for example, he was not a scholar, but he was creative. Dickens also, and the same was the case with Keats. They were sublime writers. Their writing had sublimity in them. But these were not great scholars, however, they were great creators. So there was creativity involved, which is very important for sublimity. Sublimity comes because of passions, because of emotions. It doesn't come with bookish learning, which refers to the scholarship. So this artificiality, this puerility comes when someone wants to show off his knowledge with artificial ways, and he becomes childishly silly and immature in this regard. The third fault is referred to as frigidity, which means insensitive. when you become insensitive to emotions, to when you become insensitive to the feelings of others, it means that you have got frigidity in you. This is the third fault. Frigidity, you become insensitive. So frigidity comes when you are untouched and unmoved by anything. You become frigid emotionally and mentally, insensitive. You are not moved by the beauty of nature because you are insensitive to it, and therefore there isn't any sublimity in your writing if you are frigid. Sublimity is not there because sublimity requires emotions, passions, sympathy and empathy. Empathy is a little more than sympathy, because in empathy you put yourself in another's shoes, you put yourself in place of another and you feel like him. That is called empathy. When somebody is frigid, he cannot identify himself with others. He cannot feel for others. He cannot feel the tragedy of others. And he wants to draw attention with the help of novelty. We know that there is difference between novelty and originality. Originality is a must for great literature. But novelty means that you just want to be different from others. And in order to make yourself different from others, you make use of different techniques which are not sincere. They are insincere. Frigid writers cannot describe great situation, because great situations demand that you put yourself in that position. That is, consider it empathetically. That you cannot do, and therefore you are frigid and your writing would not have sublimity in you, in it. So therefore he cannot describe emotions appropriately, and therefore he cannot appeal to readers' emotions too. So this is that next fault, frigidity. Yet another fault is called parenthesis. And parenthesis again is a kind of false sentiment. There is the overuse of emotions. There is again imbalance between the situation and the emotions. Situation is of one kind, but the emotions which is appropriate to it is not created. For example, if a situation is not pathetic, it is not full of pain, but the writer tries to arouse pathetic emotions, he would create a ridiculous effect. So these are the four faults. If these faults are there, then sublimity will not be there. And if somebody says he is sublime, we will say that it is not sublime, but it is actually फॉल्स सबलाइम. तो ये फॉल्स सबलाइम की क्वालिटीज हुई. हमने ये कहा कि अगर सबलाइम नहीं है और ये फॉल्स है, तो फिर इसमें चार मुख्तलिफ फॉल्ट्स होंगी. और ख़ासतौर पे ये फॉल्ट्स हेलेनिस्टिक एज में भी थी और 18th सेंचुरी राइटर्स में, ख़ासतौर पे पॉप ड्राइडन, जो कि अपने आप को न्यू क्लासिक बोलते थे, उनमें भी यही फॉल्ट थी, क्योंकि ये आउटर फॉर्म पे बिलीव करते थे, रूल्स फॉलो करते थे, स्पिरिट और इंस्पिरेशन को इन्होंने छोड़ा हुआ था. तो इन चार फॉल्ट्स में सबसे जो पहली फॉल्ट है वो है टर्जिडिटी की, जिसका मतलब है कि बड़े बड़े अल्फाज का इस्तेमाल करना छोटे सब्जेक्ट मैटर के लिए. तो ये दरअसल मैटर और मैनर का जोड़ जब नहीं होता तो टर्जिडिटी का फॉल्ट आता है. इसको इम्बैलेंस बिटवीन थॉट एंड स्टाइल भी कह सकते हैं. थॉट अक्सर इसमें ग्रेट नहीं होता, लेकिन जो फॉर्म है वो ग्रेट होती है, बम्बास्टिक लैंग्वेज यूज करके. और इसको लांजाइनस डिजीज बोलता है, क्योंकि ये ड्रॉपसी डिजीज की तरह है, जिसमें बंदा मोटा होता चला जाता है लेकिन अंदर से खाली खुली होता है. और ये एक गुब्बारे की तरह होता है. इसकी पोएट्री को डिजीज्ड पोइट्री का नाम दिया जाएगा, जिसमें स्टाइल तो बड़ा बम्बास्टिक, डिक्शन और हीरोइक मीटर भी बम्बास्टिक, लेकिन जो सब्जेक्ट मैटर है वो ज़बरदस्त नहीं होता. तो ऐसा पोइट ऐसे क्यों करता है? ये हमें साइकोलॉजिकल रीज़न लांजाइनस देता है, क्योंकि वो डरता है कि मेरा डिक्शन ख़राब ना हो जाए, मुझे कम दर्जा की स्टाइल को ना समझा जाए. तो इसलिए वो ये इस्तेमाल करता है बम्बास्टिक लैंग्वेज, और ये बड़े राइटर्स में भी पाया जाता है। जैसे वर्ड्सवर्थ बड़ा राइटर था, ये जब इंस्पायर्ड होता तो ज़बरदस्त पोइट्री लिखता, लेकिन ये अनइंस्पायर्ड होकर भी पोइट्री लिखता तो फिर वो फ्लैट और हॉलो और फोर्स पोइट्री होती और उसमें टर्जिडिटी होती। तो ये टर्जिडिटी जो है ये लिमिटेड नहीं है इन्फीरियर पोइट्स में, ये सुपीरियर पोइट्स में भी हो सकती है, और वो पॉइंट फिर फॉल्स सब्लाइम होगा जिसमें टर्जिडिटी पाई जाए। दूसरा फॉल्ट जिसका जिक्र वो करता है वो है प्योरिलिटी, और प्योरिलिटी से मुराद इमेच्योरिटी है और सिलीनेस है, बेवकूफ़ी है। और ये बेवकूफ़ी भी तब आती है जब कोई शोशा मारना चाहता है कि वो ज़्यादा आलिम बंदा है और इल्मियत जाहिर करने के लिए वो मस्नूई ज़रिए तलाश करता है। तो ये जो हामी है जब वो कसदन अपनी स्टाइल को बड़ा बनाना चाहता है और उसमें ये अहलियत नहीं है तो फिर प्योरिलिटी की का फॉल्ट आएगा। इन हम स्कॉलरशिप और क्रिएटिविटी में फ़र्क करते हैं। मसलन स्कॉलरशिप का बंदा बड़ा आलिम होगा लेकिन शायद वो क्रिएटिव ना हो। शेक्सपियर की हम मिसाल लेते हैं, डिकेंस, कीट्स की, ये बड़े उलमा तो नहीं थे, यानी पढ़े लिखे इतने ज़्यादा नहीं थे, लेकिन ये क्रिएटिव थे। लिहाजा सबलिमिटी जो आती है वो स्कॉलरशिप से नहीं आती, पैशंस और इमोशन से आती है, बुकिश नर्लिंग और से नहीं आती। तो प्योरिलिटी जो सिलीनेस है और जो आर्टिफिशियलिटी है ये दूसरी फॉल्ट है फॉल्स सब्लाइम के लिए। तीसरा फॉल्ट फ्रिजिडिटी है, जिसका मतलब है इनसेंसिटिव, यानी कोई शख्स दूसरे शख्स के गम को पहचानता नहीं है, उसकी ट्रेजिडी को समझता नहीं है और मुतासर नहीं होता नेचुरल नेचर चीज़ों से और दूसरी चीज़ों से। तो ये शख्स फ्रिजिड कहलाता है क्योंकि ये किसी चीज़ से मुतासर नहीं होता। जब नहीं होता तो फिर इसमें इमोशनलिटी नहीं होगी और ये ब्यूटी ऑफ नेचर को डिस्क्राइब नहीं कर सकेगा, इससे सबलिमिटी नहीं आएगी, क्योंकि सबलिमिटी में इमोशंस, पैशंस और सिंपैथी की ज़रूरत है, एम्पैथी की भी ज़रूरत है। एम्पैथी सिंपैथी से एक दर्जा ज़्यादा बेहतर है क्योंकि इसमें आप उस शख्स की जगह पर अपने आप को रखते हैं और आप फील करते हैं। अगर आप फील ना करें तो आप फ्रिजिड हैं और यूं आप अपने आप को उसके साथ आइडेंटिफाई नहीं करते, आप दूसरों की ट्रेजिडी को नहीं समझते, आप सिर्फ उनकी तवज्जो हासिल करने के लिए चीज़ को नोवेल करते हैं। और नोवेल्टी और ओरिजिनलिटी में फ़र्क है। नोवेल्टी में आप सिर्फ अपने आप को दूसरे से मुख्तलिफ साबित करने के लिए बड़े अल्फाज का इस्तेमाल करते हैं, तो ये तीसरा फॉल्ट है। चौथा फॉल्ट पेरेंथेसिस कहलाता है, और इसमें भी जो सेंटिमेंट है वो झूठा होता है या फिर ज़रूरत से ज़्यादा इमोशनलिटी दिखाई जाती है। सिचुएशन और इमोशन के दरमियान बैलेंस नहीं होता। सिचुएशन फर्ज करें पुरदर्द सिचुएशन नहीं है, लेकिन आप जो अल्फाज इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं वो बड़े पुरदर्द हैं, पैथेटिक इमोशंस मौजूद नहीं है, आप उभारने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, तो इसका इफेक्ट ये रिडिकुलस होगा। तो यूं ये चार फॉल्ट्स, अगर इन चार फॉल्ट्स को आप बहुत ही मुख्तसर अंदाज से सीखना चाहते हैं तो वो ये होंगे। सबसे पहला टर्जिडिटी। टर्जिडिटी का मतलब है इन्फ्लेटिंग वर्ड्स और एक्शंस का इस्तेमाल, ऐसे वर्ड्स का इस्तेमाल जो ज़रूरत से ज़्यादा सबलाइम लगें। जैसे और इसकी तारीफ होगी, सम आथर्स एम एट ग्रैंडर, बाज आथर्स ग्रैंडर हासिल करने की कोशिश करते हैं, बट इंस्टेड राइट इन ए बम्बास्टिक एंड इनसिंसियर स्टाइल, लेकिन वो बम्बास्टिक और इनसिंसियर स्टाइल में लिखते हैं, ये टर्जिडिटी कहलाएगा। एक लाइन डेफिनेशन प्योरिलिटी की है, जिसका मतलब इमेच्योर है। प्योरिलिटी अकर्स, ये तब होती है When authors writing and ideas are shallow, जब authors की writing और ख्यालात ये shallow हों, deep ना हो and lacking any real substance, और वाकई उसमें कोई substance ना हो, उसमें कोई कमाल ना हो। तीसरा fault parenthesis है, और ये false sentiments कहलाते हैं। Overuse of emotions को parenthesis कहा जाता है। Frigidity से मुराद है insensitivity, यानी आप एहसास नहीं कर सकते being insensitive to others, और दूसरों के लिए आप insensitive होते हैं। तो ये चार मुख्तसर तौर पे ये ऐसे होंगे, और डिटेल में ये चार हमने किए। आपको ये बात मैं फिर बताऊं, चूंकि आपने पेपर ज्वाइल किए थे उसमें बाज स्टूडेंट्स ने सिर्फ पॉइंट्स लिखे हैं, पॉइंट्स आप पेपर्स में नहीं लिखेंगे, आपने इनके जुमले बनाने। अगर आपको शक है कि आप करेक्ट जुमला नहीं कह सकते, तो फिर आप जो जुमले मैंने कहे हुए हैं इस लेक्चर में उनको भी अपने नोट्स में कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं। थैंक यू एंड गुड लक।